students. So today, welcome back to the online science class. The topic which we were discussing, it was physical and chemical changes. If you remember, last time we have discussed the topic, in previous lectures and part 2, 3 lecture, whatever you have gone through related to this chapter, you must have seen that in those lectures we discussed about elements, compounds, mixtures, and then after this the next lecture was based on chemical symbols, chemical formula. The third lecture was related to the chemical reaction and chemical equation. Okay, and along with this I have given you a brief introduction of physical changes as well. Okay, so that means in our previous classes we have gone through these topics, and at that time I have told you but these topics are going to help you to understand in detail about chemical changes, right? So today I'll be discussing, our main topic will remain chemical changes. We will discuss this topic in detail. Okay, so we will perform some activities also. I'll show you some experiments that how the chemical change takes place. Okay, so that will be very interesting for you people. Firstly, let's discuss again the remaining part of physical changes which in last class we haven't done. Okay, and after that directly without any delay we will move to the chemical changes, which is our main topic of discussion. Okay, so firstly let me describe physical changes. Let me revise it once again so that you can get better understanding. See, physical changes, I have told you last time, a change is said to be physical only when if there is any change in shape, size or state. Okay, so what is a physical change? A change is said to be physical if there is a change in shape, size or state of the substance. But what was the very important condition that should not be there in physical change? What that condition was, you remember? It was like no new substance should be formed. No new substance should be formed. That was the second condition. And the third was that physical change can be reversible or it can be irreversible. But most of the times a physical change is always what? It is always reversible, right? So mostly physical changes reversible, but with few exceptions in which it is reversible. I have given you example last time, if you remember. I have torn the pages into few pieces, and then if I ask you to join all the pages and just make it one paper, the same paper again, is it possible? No, that cannot be done without crushing, without grinding, without mixing. Okay, that all properties, that all processes needs to be done, only then our paper can be made, but it cannot be rejoined again, okay, to form the same paper. So that means it was irreversible in that case. For example, this glass I'm having, if I break this glass, okay, if I break it, can you again join all the pieces to form the same glass again? No. That means breaking of a glass is a reversible change, because when I break it, no new substance will be formed. Okay students, is there any new substance formation will be there when I break this glass? No ma'am, no new substance will be formed. But yes, as you cannot rejoin it to form the same glass again, that is the reason we call this physical change as irreversible. Clear? So difference is clear to you? Reversible means which can original form. And irreversible means the change which cannot be changed back into its original form. Okay? So that means physical changes mostly they are reversible, but few exceptions are there in which it is irreversible. Okay? Now let's move to the topic chemical change. Right? As in the case of physical change, there is a change in shape, size, style, and state. Here in chemical change, there is a change in chemical properties. Change in chemical properties. Why? Why there is so? Because new substance is formed. Because new substance is formed. So that means in case of chemical change, always a new substance formed. Okay? While in case of physical change, no new substance is formed. This difference is clear? Next, when new substance will be formed, there will be change in chemical properties. But in physical change, as there is no new substance formation, so no change in chemical properties, only change in physical properties. We will write change in physical properties. In physical change, that means in this change, the change will take place only in physical properties, not in chemical properties as it takes place in case of chemical changes. Clear, students? Now let me give you some examples. For example, and secondly, before giving the example, let me give you the third difference. These are always irreversible. These are always irreversible. Means permanent changes. We call it permanent changes. Permanent changes, why? Because we cannot bring it back to its original form. Okay? We cannot bring it easily. There is some process we need, some chemical process we need again to bring it back to its original form. Right? So that means these are mostly irreversible, or we call them permanent. Okay? Now let's give you some examples. What are the various examples of chemical change? Examples are, firstly, burning of wood or paper. Okay? Burning of wood or paper. I can say cooking or spoiling of food. Right? So, and in this case, physical change, you must remember that I have told you the physical changes are those in which change in state. So I have told you some processes like melting, freezing, evaporation, condensation. All these are the physical changes. While here, burning of wood, burning of paper. If I burn any paper or any wood, what will happen? After burning, ash will be formed. Right? And that ash, its properties are just different from the paper or the wood which we have burned. So that means the ash is a new substance which is getting formed, and its properties are entirely different from its original properties. So that means what kind of change it is? It is chemical change. Right? Here next you can see cooking of food. Whenever you cook food at your home, what happens? Originally, its property was something different. Then after cooking, you add a number of spices, salt, sugar, or whatever you like. Okay, all the spices like mirchi and all. Okay, so when you are adding all these spices, so what happens? After cooking, its properties get changed. So that means that cannot be, it can it be done? For example, you have prepared the vegetable of say any god, okay, bottle god, which you call in Hindi ghee, you have prepared the vegetable of that. Can you bring it back to its original form? Can you, after cooking, can you bring it back to the bottle god original form, what it was? No, it cannot be done. Okay, once it is cut, once it is cooked, all its properties have got changed. After cooking, it becomes softer, its taste changes, okay, its shape changes, right? So that means totally the new substance is getting formed. So it cannot be brought back to its original form. That is the reason we call cooking or spoiling of food or burning of food, all these are chemical changes, right? And one more example, rusting of iron. Rusting of iron. This is also a chemical change. Now you must be saying, ma'am, iron, rusting of iron. Rusting means it is the process by which rust is formed over the iron, right? Layer of rust is formed. Brown layer deposit that we call rust, it is formed over iron objects. So that is how rusting takes place. Is it chemical change? You must be saying, ma'am, no new substance is formed here. Iron is iron always. No. Actually, over the iron, the brown layer which gets deposited, we call it rust. That means iron has changed its form from iron to iron oxide, that is rust, and we call it chemical change. Now, the next topics which we will discuss will be all related to the chemical changes, right? So firstly, let us discuss about rusting of iron.
Because it was kept in open air outside, where
Because of these two conditions, this iron nail has got deposited with iron oxide, which the brown layer covering, which you can see, right? So this brown layer covering is called as rust, okay? So that means iron corrodes away, it gets rusting when it is kept in oxygen and water. So what is the way? How can we prevent this rusting? You must have seen when the new buildings are getting prepared, where the iron objects are getting used in that building, it's always painted, okay? Or in somewhere it is oil. So how can rusting be prevented? How can rusting be prevented? So I'm writing here prevention. Prevention. There are various ways, but let me explain you. Prevention can be done by the use of oiling. Means by oiling the iron object so that it doesn't come in contact with the water or with the oxygen directly. Oiling. The next method, it can be painting. Okay. As it is done in your homes, painting is done on the iron objects to prevent it from rusting. And the third is galvanization. That is galvanization. So what is galvanization? Galvanization means to galvanize. And what is that galvanize means? Galvanize means depositing zinc over iron, okay? Depositing or painting zinc over iron, or instead of depositing, you can use the word coating. So what is done in galvanization? Galvanization is the process of preventing the iron object from rusting. And what is done in this process in galvanization? In galvanization, over the iron objects, coating of zinc metal is done, because zinc doesn't get corroded easily. Zinc doesn't get deposition of rust easily. So that is the reason over the iron objects, zinc coating is done, okay, to prevent it from rusting, right? So this is how layer of zinc gets deposited. You must have seen pipelines in your cities. Okay, all the pipelines which are there used in your cities, it's all galvanized. It's all galvanized. Why? Because without galvanization, if we directly put the pipelines inside the earth, what will happen? There is a lot of moisture, a lot of air. So because of that, all the rust will take place over the iron pipelines, and the pipelines will get eroded, they will get rusting, and they will get leakage. Right? So that means a lot of money wastage will take place if the iron pipelines will not be coated by the zinc metal. So that is the reason zinc metal coating is done over the iron objects to prevent it from rusting. Okay? So that we call galvanization. Two more methods are there which are not in the books, but yes, just for an extra knowledge I'm telling you. Those two methods are tinning and alloying. So what is tinning? In case of tinning, tin metal gets deposited over iron, and in case of alloying, two or more metals are combined so that the pure iron can be changed to some another metal, and it gets the less condition of rusting, right? So for the time being, I am just stopping here so that you can go through these topics clearly. And in our next class, we will discuss about browning of vegetables that takes place due to what? It's a chemical change, okay? And due to what? I'll explain in the next class. And there are some more chemical equations, okay, or chemical reactions are there, with the help of which I'll explain, with the help of some reactions, I'll explain you how those chemical changes takes place. For the time being, just go through the video, go through the lecture, go through the notes, and try to understand the topic in a clear manner, so that for the next lecture you are having a deep knowledge. Thank you. Have a nice day.